listening to Halloween Unleashed.
What did you do with Marnie?
She's on the cutting room floor.
The cult of personality. I know your anger, I know your dreams. Good day, horror fans. Welcome to what we'll call the inaugural episode of The Cutting Room Floor, where we will have artists on once or twice a month to discuss their future projects, history in the business, as much as we are all fans of the industrial side of what these artists do. And today, my first guest is the incomparable Matthew Reed. Matt, how you doing today?
Pretty good, man. How are you?
I'm doing all right. You're a unique individual in this hobby, I would say.
I don't know about that.
Well, I say that because, as you know, and if anyone's listened to Chris Morgan's Halloween Unleashed podcast, it's not difficult to have beef with people in this hobby. It can sometimes be a toxic environment, would you agree?
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's been that way for years.
From talking to various people, and we've known each other for a few months now, you've been an admin in the Horror Forever group for pretty much since its inception. One reason I started that group was to kind of have a community without so much toxicity, but I've never once seen a person have a negative thing to say about Matthew Reed.
Well, I try my best, man.
Every time someone talks about you, he's the nicest guy in the world, always best hair in the business. So I think you're a unique individual in that aspect. No one's ever had a bad thing to say about you other than the occasional people that want to, you know, talk shit about your product when they don't know anything about it, but we'll leave that one alone.
Right on.
Start with a little bit of backstory on you. Where are you from and where you live?
Well, I'm from South Point, Ohio. That's, if you can't tell by the name, it's the southern tip of Ohio. So I live in the tri-state area right by Kentucky, West Virginia, all that.
Where do you live now? Still in that same area?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, cool. You got a girlfriend, fiance? You married?
I got a girlfriend.
How is she in regards to the whole industry, as far as you having a whole shed in your backyard dedicated to making horror movie props?
Oh, she's super supportive about it. She's always pushed me to do better, and you know, she even critiques my work and stuff, so it kind of keeps me on my toes.
That's she's always wonderful. Good. Having support, sometimes, you know, having family or you know, seeing it can be a little weird for them, or they can not be so supportive. That's always good to see you got passion on both sides for you.
Definitely.
Do y'all have any kids?
No, we had two dogs and three cats, though.
Oh, that's plenty of kids right there.
They're enough for us, yeah.
So how did you first get into the business? Like, what was your first experience with horror movies when you were a kid, you know, haunted house? What was it?
Well, I'd say it all, my mom's the one to blame for all this. Since I can remember, when I was just a toddler, really, I mean, I remember her waking me up when I was, you know, maybe 4 or 5, just to watch Aliens on TV, because she knew that was one of my favorite movies. So she really kind of kickstarted the whole thing, and it just snowballed from there.
I had a similar one myself. My sister was too scared to watch movies by herself. She'd go get her little 6-year-old brother to watch with her.
Right on.
What was your first dipping into the making of masks and such? When did you first start dabbling in that?
Well, since I've been into the hobby, I've always kind of been into like refinishing and painting and all that. When I first started out, I would say I was probably around 14 or 15, had no clue what I was doing. My first mask I repainted, I used latex house paint, which, if you know anything about latex house paint, it was just a mess. We'll put it that way. I won't even say what the mask is, because it's actually a really sought after mask nowadays. So I'll leave that part out so I don't get hung. But after that, I just kind of stayed with collecting, and I would, you know, just refinish like mass produced stuff here and there. And I didn't really start making them until about 2011 or 2012. I actually have some of my work behind me. My very first mask I made was this Leatherface here. it was actually a ground up sculpt. If you can, I don't know if you can see in the video, but I mean, I didn't really know how to paint all that well back then. So you can see it's still cracking. It's not in the greatest shape, but, yeah, that was my very first mask. I still have the mold to this day.
That's really good for a ground up. And that actually leads me to my next one. What is the name of your FX company for those who don't know?
It's House of Horror Productions.
And was that started in 2011, 2012?
No, that actually started in 2017 when I actually started producing my own. So it hasn't been around that long. I've been doing this for a while, but haven't really been in the business very long.
Gotcha. What was the first mask that you began making on a regular basis that you created yourself?
The first one I started producing was the Starkiller, and I actually have one blank left back there. I don't know if you can see it. I bought a master from another individual, and it derived from the original 75 Kirk, and I tried to margin that just by pretty much piecing out the clay press of it and trying to sculpt it larger. I know easier ways nowadays to do it thanks to a friend of mine, but yeah, that was the first mask that I produced regularly.
And that one's no longer in production?
No, it's discontinued. I think Andrew from the old Jack in the Box mask actually has the master now. I think he's Black Jack Mask or something on eBay, so you might catch a blank every now and then pop up.
So I know I checked out your website, and if I'm correct, you have four masks on there at the moment, the two H4s and the two H1s, or is the H1 and the H2?
Yeah.
So were both of those or any of those all ground-up sculpts, or were they recast of anything else?
The Fright Mask was another retool of the same master that the Starkiller came from. It's just I tried, I just kind of pieced out the sculpt and tried to sculpt a larger. I just tried to get my proportions a little better than I did with the Starkiller with that one. And the H4 is pretty much, I mean, I'm not going to call it a ground up because I had where I did a silicone mold of the Fright Mask. I still had the sculpt intact, so I shaved off all the features of it and just built off of that to make my H4. So both those, I would consider both those retools.
I was probing the community, asking a few people, because I've got a couple people in the hobby. I won't name names, but you know who I consult when I want to know, you know, just the since they're very experienced, the overall best opinions of things, and then just seeing different people around. Your H4 seems to be the most popular one among the community. It's the most common one I see, certainly, and people never have a bad thing to say about it. I'm planning to get one myself, because honestly, I can see a few blanks hanging on that rack up there. It's a good H4.
Yeah, I got a few in progress now. I got another one I got to start today, actually.
And you make two versions of that one, yes, a clean and a more weathered version.
Right, yeah. That was actually, I can't remember off the top of my head who it was, but it was a customer that kind of came up with that idea. And just wanted it really nasty and grungy, so I kind of ran with it from there. And people seemed to like it an awful bit.
Sort of like what Terry Lambert does with his H4. He's got the clean and right. The dirty, though in the movie it never really is dirty. But I like seeing people do that because I think the concept's good. Because it's sort of like the H2 versus H1. You know, it's a more dirty, weathered look. And it seems to be people prefer a weathered look with their mask. Personally, I like all my hockey masks, my Myers mask to be on the cleaner end, but weather seems, I would say, to be the more popular of the two.
Yeah, I kind of flip-flop back and forth. Sometimes I want a real clean, like, ghostly finish where just mostly just flesh kind of accents certain areas instead of dirt and grime, but I've always been a fan of the Halloween 2 mask, so I love the nastiness of it.
So I asked people in different Facebook groups to submit some questions. I only got two. But the first one's from Alexander Wilkins, and he wants to know the name of your new H1 sculpt.
My new sculpt is Death Prowler 75 is what I'm calling it. It's kind of a playoff, of course, when abbreviated, it'd be DP75. So it's kind of a playoff of the Dom Post 75 Kirk. And also two of my favorite masks, the Night Prowler and the Deathstalker from the old MMP days. I'm a huge fan of like the old school indie sculpts. So it's just kind of a homage to them, regardless of how you feel about them.
That new 75, I was seeing the thread when you first posted it. What was the process of you getting, what was that mask originally? And did you recast it? Did you do any changes to it? Or is it essentially the same as what the mask that you got?
It's pretty much a proper enlargement of the original master I got. I sharpened the features quite a bit, as I mean, they were pretty washed out from it being such a small casting and due to the enlarging process. So, I sharpened the lips up quite a bit and just reshaped the jawline, because the original master is just, well, actually, hang on, I'll grab it and I'll show y'all. It's cool, but it's still just kind of washed out. The shape's kind of thrown off. It's kind of, it's kind of bloated looking. You can see it's kind of small. So, I mean, it needed quite a bit of work. The bare bones are there. And here's the new master. So you can see it quite a bit larger. It's kind of hard to see the details just due to the color of the urethane, but I'm pretty happy with how it turned out.
And I believe you told me you're going to make three versions of that mask, a Kirk, a Halloween 1, and a Halloween 2.
Yeah, that's the plan.
Okay, fantastic. I know you said you're making them enlarged. I know people like Brandon Zach, and shout out Brandon, with a bigger head will appreciate that.
Yeah.
I know. I think you said you're going to send him a test one to see if it fits his big old head.
Yeah, that'll help me out a little bit too.
Now I see you're wearing that WMP shirt. Shout out to Chris Morgan.
Oh yeah, represent. Last,
never go away. But another question was from Eric Hofer and asked if you have any plans to make an H6.
I do have an H6 master. It was I'm probably going to butcher his name here. His name was James Fiera or Ferrara or something along those lines. I believe his was a ground-up sculpt. I do have plans to maybe tool that in the future and release it. As of right now, it's kind of on the back burner because I have my H5 I'm working on. And after the H5, I'd kind of like to branch out and kind of do some original sculpts.
Yeah, I don't think I've seen any of your original work, but I know I've seen that the steps you've been making with that H5, and it's coming along really nice. I know right now the hobby's kind of, you know, again, this is just my opinion, but kind of short on good quality H5s. Other than the Revenge of the Fifth, I haven't really seen one that I've been pleased with.
Right, yeah.
So, future sculpts, you know, you want to do some custom work yourself. What, anything you got specifically, or you just want to kind of just mess around and see what you can come up with?
I have a few ideas. As far as just original work, I've always kind of wanted to sculpt, like, some witches. There's just something about witches that, like, screams Halloween to me, so I'd really like to tackle one of those. I'd also like to maybe do a couple of Universal monsters, you know, like Phantom of the Opera and things such as that, the Creature of the Black Lagoon. So we'll see if I can get some time. I might start working on those.
Now I see a Freddy Krueger behind you. Is that something you're planning on, or is that just something personal of yours?
That was actually my second sculpt. It's ground up. It's too small to wear because, again, at the time I didn't really know what I was doing. I was just kind of experimenting. But, yeah, I sculpted this back in 2012, I believe it was. But, yeah, I don't ever plan on releasing. The sculpt's not in that great of shape. It's starting to crack in certain areas. But, yeah, that was actually a ground up of mine.
You live and learn. And certainly you've mastered the technique over the years. The products you make now, and I'm excited to see that. The new DP75, you've certainly mastered your craft.
I appreciate that, man. Thanks.
All right, well, that's about all the questions I have. Do you have anything specifically you want to plug or announce or discuss?
No, but I'd like to just, you know, thank all my supporters for, you know, being with me these past couple of years and continuing to support me. And I really appreciate all of you.
And on that note, I really appreciate you being the inaugural guest here, man. I know for the fans watching and for you as well, I know I want to just say, you know, bear with me as I get this down a little bit. You know, Matt will attest that this morning was the first time that I had attempted this at all, and we were taking about 30 minutes just working through the bugs and getting this settled. I appreciate your patience with that.
Oh, yeah, man.
I appreciate you. I want to give you a shout-out for helping me with the Horror Forever group, being an admin there. Helping manage the community along with John and Chris, Brandon, Joshua, all of which I'm going to try to get those guys on the show as well, because they're all fantastic artist. Brandon's very known in the hobby. You guys hear him on Halloween Unleashed with Chris every so often. Him and Chris are very knowledgeable. Yeah. Shout out to those guys, too.
New episode's out right now. I'm going to listen to it while I work in the shop this evening.
Oh, yeah. Just listen to Chris's new Halloween 2 episode yesterday. It's really funny. More Chris Morgan humor in that one.
Right.
thanks for being on here, Matt. Really appreciate it. And I can't wait to see that new Halloween 1 when you get finished, since I'm going to get that first H1.
Right on, man. Well, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
I appreciate it, man. We'll be right back.